Hi friends, today in this video we are going to see one of the favorite exceptions that occurs probably when it occurs in every Java developer's life, that is null pointer exception. What is basically a null pointer exception? What are its causes? How to resolve null pointer exception? So let's start with it. So firstly, I will create a new Java project. So what you will do, I will create a class over here. I will keep the name as new demo, calling the camel case in Java. I will create a method over here. Simple method, just add to variable. Make it simple. This one functionality is just to add two variables. Okay. And keep the variables as hard code the values. This for simplified purpose. So what I'll do, I will first initialize the class with null value. First instance with null value. With demo. Now let's see what gets printed. Yeah, as you can see on the screen, it's showing the null pointer exception right away. So, null pointer exception occurs when you are trying to access or modify object's value which has not been initialized. So, in order to avoid null pointer exception, there are ways. Firstly, you can do is to if it's pointed to null, then you have to initialize it. You have to check the condition if it's pointing to null. So, what I will do here, just check the condition with equal to. And note here, I'm using equal to instead of dot equals, because the difference between equal to and dot equals is that equal to compares the reference addresses of the objects to different objects or objects variables, and dot equals compares the content or the values in the two instances or object variables. So I'm purposefully using equals instead of dot equals. So if it's null, I'll just get a new instance, this is a new operator. Now let's see what happens. Yeah, the result is of add is 5. Yeah, so now the null point is gone. So I meant that we have to use equal to instead of dot equals. So I see what happens when I use dot equals. Let's have a comment just call for the meanwhile. I will compare it with dot equals. As I previously told, the dot equals compares both the content which are present between the two variables. So here what happens is that the new demo is instead meaning null value, and null is being compared to null, and so the result is true and it results into the null pointer exception. We'll see now. So that's why we have to avoid using a dot equals in order to get rid of null pointer exception. So these are some simple tricks to you can use to get rid of null pointer exceptions. I'm sure every one of us might get aware of in one's life during the programming for handling null pointer exceptions. That's it, done. Okay.